Hi, everyone, and good afternoon and happy Thursday. Thanks so much for joining us today for what I know will be a really fantastic and informative webinar. My name is Sandy Elson, and on behalf of the travel professional community and homebasedtravelagent.com, I want to welcome all of you and thank you so much for taking time out of your day to join us today. I am very pleased that our host today is Passport Online. Passport Online is the industry leader in delivering comprehensive digital marketing solutions to travel agents. This includes websites, email marketing tools, and social media programs, all geared to work for and with the travel agent community. Our speaker for Passport Online is Sarah Bauman, Marketing and Product Analyst. Sarah has been with Passport Online since 2000. She started out on the content team and is currently the social media specialist. Sarah graduated from the Oregon Institute of Technology in 2009 with a Bachelor of Science in Information Technology and Application Development and a minor in marketing, which has helped her become Passport Online's expert in social media, as well as helping in the development of ESP. Sarah lives in Oregon with her Chorky Lola. And for those of you who don't know, a Chorky is a Chihuahua and Yorkshire Terrier mix. And Sarah loves trying all the new food carts Portland has to offer. Sarah's topic today is motivate holiday travel sales on your website and social media. Very important, very timely, and very interesting to all of us. As always, we really appreciate the support we get from Passport Online. Before we get started, please remember that you are all muted, but we welcome your questions. You can type in your questions at any time during the webinar in the question area you see on the right-hand panel of your screen. At the end of the presentation, we will get to as many questions as we can. So I'm going to turn the microphone over to Sarah so she can tell us how to motivate our holiday sales. Welcome, Sarah.
Hello, everyone, and good afternoon. I'm really excited to talk with everyone about this today because I think this topic is pretty timely. So we're going to talk about how to motivate holiday travel sales on your website and social media. Before we get started, though, I want to really quickly talk about who we are, Passport Online, and just give you a little bit of company background, and then we'll get into all the good stuff. So we have more than 20 years experience developing technology products for travel agents. We power more than 6,000 sites and have more than 6 million unique consumers shop on those sites every month. Also, it's important to point out, all of our products are only for the travel industry. We don't do websites or social media solutions for anything else. So all of our expertise is around travel. Participation in our social media program includes more than 1,500 agency Facebook pages, and those Facebook pages reach nearly 1 million Facebook consumer users. So that gives you an idea that it's a pretty popular product. Our network features the industry's top 100 suppliers, which are the cruise lines, tour operators, packagers, wholesalers, hospitality organizations. You've heard of them all, I'm sure. And we have 95% of all cruise berths, 15,000 plus unique itineraries, more than 130,000 distinct departures, and 9,000 plus consortia exclusives. So if you're part of a consortia, chances are we probably have some exclusive offers in there for them that you can take advantage of. Now let's get to the good stuff that I know you're all waiting for. We want to talk a little bit about focusing on holiday travel options. So I first wanted to talk about some ideas for different types of holiday offers that you can promote. And this is just more in general. It's not you can promote in any specific way, just some ideas to get you thinking. So there's some Christmas market cruises, which are quite interesting. So I took a look, and it looks like here's a number of suppliers that are providing those. So that's one idea for holiday offers you can start thinking about promoting. And they range in price from high-end with A&K, and Crystal, and then you're moving down into a more affordable price range. So depending on whether you have luxury clientele or more not luxury clientele, then here's some options. Christmas market tours, if they don't want to do a cruise, but they maybe want to still see the Christmas markets, here's some land options. And just various holiday getaways. I saw that CETA had some great ones. There were some Santa Claus trips, some other interesting things like that that they were offering. So those looked fun. And also just Christmas and New Year's cruises in general with the mass market cruise lines. They have all kinds of different departures over the holidays, so those might be another one to promote and just get people thinking about, you know, hey, maybe you don't want to do the gift exchange this year. Instead, plan a cruise and take your family and have a great time and don't have to worry about cooking. So here's an example of what an agency has done to promote one of their own unique holiday travel trips. So every year they do this Christmas shopping tour to Chicago. So they've created a page on their site under our special trips where they feature this and showcase when it is, how much it is, and they just go to Chicago, spend the day shopping, they include bus transfers, all that. So good idea if you have something like this that you offer to put together a nice page about that and get the word out. You could also take this page and link to it from social media. You can make a post about it saying, hey, if you didn't know already, here's our annual Christmas shopping trip. Here are an example of some various offers that are showing up within our NextSight system. You're seeing a cruise from Star Clippers. You're seeing a Rose Pole package, another offer from Star Clippers. And here's just another zoomed in view so you can see that a little bit better. I just wanted to show you the navigation around that first. And here's some more examples on just a different website. This is just showing some of the more general cruises that just happen to take place over the holidays. So you can see that here's even more ideas of things you can feature. And one of the other things I saw that one of our agencies did was they created what's called an offer group, which is just a way to display several offers in one area, and they included some really cool offers for the holidays. And they wrote this nice little description at the top to talk about holiday travel. And then you can see that they mixed in some land and some cruise, so have a little bit of everything. And just wanted to show a zoomed in view of that so you could more easily see what is involved in these. A little description of the itinerary, a photo, some pricing, how long it is. And here's another example of how another agency called out some holiday travel. They have this area on their cruises page where they've featured this cruise spotlight, and they've chosen to feature this Western Caribbean holiday cruise. You see right here. And here's a zoomed in view of that just so you can see it a little bit better. And I think this is really interesting because selecting one, maybe two offers and putting them in a pretty prominent place on your website is a great way to call attention to that, because even though people may want to get away for the holidays, sometimes they're not thinking about it. And they're not always thinking about it now. They may wait until, you know, Thanksgiving or closer to Christmas and then decide, oh, now we want to, you know, go somewhere for the holiday. And by then, it's kind of too late. Stuff might be booked up or really expensive. So, you know, always a good idea to let people know as early as possible. And here's another example. An agency just has this celebrity promotion here on their website. Holiday gift to you, free perk of your choice. I thought this was quite interesting. You can choose which one you want. That way people can pick what's more important to them and that it's valid for holiday sailings. I thought was pretty cool because a lot of these are only valid for, you know, kind of off-season types of things. So this was a great promotion. And here's just a little bit bigger view of that. And when you click on that, it actually goes and shows all the different sailings that this particular promotion is available on. So that was a nice touch too. So, you know, people are interested. They don't have to call you to say, you know, hey, which of these can I get this deal on? They can actually click, see, and go, oh, okay, this one will work, or I like the price on that, things like that. So when they call you, they have a much better idea of what they want to buy. And here is another example of an agency where they're calling out some of their special group trips, again, like we talked about before with the group trip to for Christmas. Here's another one where they're talking about a Christmas spectacular bus trip, the Thanksgiving cruise. And again, I zoomed in a little bit so that you can see these a bit better here. So an annual Thanksgiving cruise on Holland America, or a Christmas spectacular bus trip to the Biltmore Mansion, Callaway Gardens. That sounds like it would be kind of a fun thing to do. It's not necessarily exactly over Christmas, but it would be a fun thing to do before. So anything like this that you have, again, showcase that on your website. Let people know about it. Make it easy for them to find it, because if you're not advertising it, they don't know that you have this great group tour or promotion available. So another thing I want to talk about is start your holiday email campaigns now. You can use these to drive traffic to your website with emails and promote your preferred suppliers. and drive consumers back to your website to see that offer, plus give them the opportunity to search for additional offers. Maybe one of the offers that you included in your email was really interesting to them. Maybe the dates didn't work or it was a little too expensive, but once they're on your website, they can always search around. Maybe they'll see something else that they go, oh, this is perfect. This is what I'm looking for. So again, every opportunity you have to get something in front of them, let them know, and drive them back to your website. So let's talk about that a little bit more. So we're going to showcase some holiday travel options in this email here. And I just put together an example one. Here's the CETA offer that I was talking about, Christmas Santa Claus, that I thought was pretty interesting. And then there's also a Star Clippers cruise here to just promote this cruise through Asia for Christmas, which I thought was kind of interesting. It's a different thing than maybe going to the Caribbean or Mexico, which might be what people think of if they're thinking, I want to get away for the holiday. So remind them there's other options. So with our email marketing tools, you can create this whole email in there. And then what happens is when they click on more details on either of these, they're going to go back to a landing page on your website, and they're going to see that offer. They can read all about it. They can click on Contact Us and get more information. That'll send an email to you saying, hey, this here's the person's information, their name, their phone number, their email address, and here's the offer they were looking at. So that once you get that and you call them, you already know what they're interested in purchasing. So you don't have to ask them a whole bunch of questions. So you're a little further along in the process. So if I'm a consumer and I'm at this point, I think, oh, this sounds really fun, but you know, maybe that's not long enough, or maybe that's too expensive, or you know, Helsinki sounds fun, but maybe I want to go, you know, more southern Europe. Maybe I want to go to Spain or Greece. I'm on your website, so I can actually use the navigation here to go to vacations, cruises, your homepage, something like that, and explore around a little bit more, do a search, find something else that fits more closely with what I'm looking for. So in addition to promoting just holiday offers, you could also create an email to showcase winter escapes. Because as we know, when December and January roll around, people want to get somewhere sunny. They don't necessarily want to be in the cold weather anymore. So here's an example. Put this together about holiday escapes. There's the Virgin Islands and Sandals Barbados. Again, you can click on more details on either one of those. And when you do, it's going to take you back to the website. So you can see here, this one is valid not just for the holiday season, but through May. So this is a good option if they decided, oh, you know what, we don't really want to go anywhere for the holidays, but we do want to get out somewhere in, you know, January, February, something like that. These kind of offers are great to promote now, too, if you get people thinking about that. And it's also not too early to start talking about the holidays on social media. A lot of people start talking about Christmas in July and planning your holiday getaways. And as you all know, that you're going to get the best price on booking your trips the earlier out you do it. So even now is probably getting pretty close to last minute, but definitely not too early because people are going to start thinking about it and start shopping really soon here. So one idea would be, as we discussed before, promote holiday travel. So here's a great idea for a post. You may wish you had as many vacation days as Santa. You can still book a great vacation with the time you do have. And it's just got a fun picture showing, you know, Santa somewhere fun. These are just creative ways to let people know about some options. Here's another one that is pretty interesting. Book your all-inclusive holiday vacation now. And talking about some of the great things that are happening at the Club Med resorts. So this is neat because it's telling you what the savings are, when you can go, what they have planned. Honestly, I'm looking at this going, well, that sounds like a great place for me to go for the holidays because it sounds pretty fun. That's another example. And here's one from August. Excited about your holiday travel plans this year. Still plenty of time. Fun picture with a gal in the holiday hat. So another idea might be to promote culinary travel because one of the big things around the holidays is food. So that goes right along with culinary travel. So an idea for that might be promote a destination that's pretty famous for food and tie that into the holidays. So here's when we're talking about a food and wine destination being New Orleans, talking about some of the great food that's there, and then giving an idea of how about spending New Year's there and enjoying a delicious meal. I have actually been there, and the food is amazing. I would love to be there over New Year's or Christmas because eating all of that great food would be much, much better than cooking. So this one would resonate pretty strongly with me. So another idea is to ask questions. This is a great way on social media to get people to interact with you, which is what we're all trying to do on social media. We're trying to get our customers to engage with us. We don't want them to just click like because that's kind of passive. We want them to talk to us. We want them to ask questions, provide feedback, things like that. So asking them questions is a great way to get that conversation started. So here's one where you're asking them if they can name this place and showing them just a small portion of the picture. And we've tied it into the holidays with this mention about the display of more than 200,000 Christmas lights. So it's another way you can bring that holiday message into something that may not necessarily be exactly holiday related. So you can also suggest destinations. Here is one where we're talking about Christmas markets in Germany and Austria. So people might go, oh, you know, I might have thought about Germany, but I didn't realize Austria had that going on too. That's interesting. So again, just trying to give people options, letting them know what's out there, because consumers don't always know as well as we do what all these great holiday offers are and where they can go and where is having great holiday celebrations. So another idea you could suggest, exploration. Maybe you have clients who are more adventurous, and so they don't want to just go to a beach or sit on a cruise ship or anything like that. They want to get out and do something more active, do something that everyone else isn't doing. They want to create those memories that they're going to have forever, and that when they get back from their trip, their friends are going to be like, I wish I had went on that trip. Who booked that for you? I want to do that. So here's another idea, suggesting a cruise to Antarctica. And a great way to do that might be, you know, letting them know it's not going to be crowds, even during the busy holiday season. You could talk even more about how unique of a destination this is and, you know, more of the numbers of people who go there, things like that. So this promotion is the secret to social media and to your website. And that's the way you're going to get traffic. That's the way you're going to get clients to purchase things from you. So you want to make sure you're always promoting in every channel. And if possible, tying your promotions back together. So when you're promoting something through social media, you want to tie it to your website. When you're promoting something on your website, you want to tie it to social media, email, all of it. So promote your website. And make sure that people know that it's important to you. Because if your website isn't important to you, it's not going to be important to your clients. Make sure you refer customers back to it. If you have really compelling information on there that would be helpful for them, things like packing tips or know before you go or, you know, airport traffic delays, website links, anything like that that you think is going to be helpful for them, make sure that you're referring them to your website. The more you do that, the more they're going to learn to go there, not only to help themselves with these kinds of questions, but potentially find something else that you're promoting on there that they're interested in, because they might not even be thinking about a trip, but they might see a deal and go, wow, I wasn't planning on anything, but this is an amazing deal, and I can't really not book this. So also include your website on your business card, in your email signature, on your invoices. If you have an auto hold message on your office phone or anything like that, make sure you include your website on there. Maybe even on your outgoing voicemail message. Anytime you can include that and refer people back to it is great, because then they may not know your website if they just happen to have, you know, your phone number that they got from a friend and they're calling you. They don't necessarily know your website, but if your auto hold message is telling them, they may go, oh, okay, well, while I'm sitting here on hold, let me pull this up and take a peek. Could find something that interests them. Are you emailing your customers? And you want to make sure you are using social media. And when you're using social media, make sure that you're linking to your website from all of your social media accounts. I'm going to specifically show you how to do that on Facebook, but you can also do that on Twitter, you can do it on Instagram, you could do it on your blog. Any social media channel that you're active on, you want to make sure you absolutely have a link to your website, because if somebody wants to get in touch with you, you absolutely want to make it as easy as possible for them. You don't want people to have to work in order to buy something from you. So one of the key tips is to make sure that your about area includes your website URL. And when you put that in there, Facebook will automatically make that a clickable link for you, and it'll display on your Facebook page all the time. So here we're looking at an example of a Facebook page for My Travel Elf. And you can see down here at the bottom, it actually has their website. The other great things I love about when you actually fill out all of your information on Facebook is they'll actually do things like the open now or close now when you fill in your business hours, so that when people are looking at it, they can see, oh, they're open right now. I didn't think they would be. Let me give them a call. And if you include your physical address, they will actually include a map to that address. You can also post your phone number on Facebook. And it does have a little call symbol, so if someone's looking at Facebook and looking at your Facebook page on their mobile phone, they can just click on that little phone icon, and they don't even have to try to write down or copy and paste that phone number or anything like that. So, again, do everything you can to make it as easy as possible for people to get in touch with you and find you. So you also want to add your social media links to your website, because if they're on your website, you also want to make it as easy as possible for them to be following you on Facebook and seeing all this great content you're posting on there. So my suggestion would be to choose either the header or the footer of your site and then add them in there. That way you're making sure that they're on every single page of your website. So it doesn't matter what they're looking at on your website, they can always see your social media links. That way if they, you know, go to the homepage and they're still not sure yet, they're just getting there, they haven't decided if they're, you know, willing to follow you on social media or not yet, but they start looking at some offers, searching around, reading some pages, and they go, oh, this is great information, I want to start following them, to go back somewhere else to try to find out where was it that I saw that link, right up there at the top. So here are some examples of where people have added their social media links. As you can see right here, they have their Facebook and Twitter, and I also love that they have their phone number and email address listed right there, because again, if I maybe don't want to follow them on Facebook, but I want to call them and ask a question, I don't want to have to search around and try to find their phone number. I could just look at it and go, oh, here it is right here. I get that easily. And here's another example of Brevard, where they have all of their social media links included in the top. They've got their Google+, their blog, Facebook, and an email link, which I think is great. So another idea is to make sure that you list your agency as the place that you work on your personal Facebook page. I see a lot of people that miss out on this opportunity, and I think it's really important because a lot of people have crossover between their clients and their friends. And so if you have a friend that's like, oh, I know Mary's a travel agent, I should talk to her about this trip I want to book. You also still want to make it really, really, really easy for them to get to your agency page. You want to make it so that they don't have to think. You don't want them to have to send you a message and say, you know, hey, what's the link to your agency Facebook page, or what's your website URL, or anything like that. You want them to just be able to look, see it, and go, oh, okay, here it is, click, go to it, find what they're looking for. And as we see, that's what they would click on to get that, and then they could like or send a message to your business page. So here's kind of a quick recap on what we covered so far, which is you want to create fun holiday offers and promote those on your website. Be proactive, start emailing your customers to think about their holiday travel, and post holiday social media messages now. Since the summer's come to an end, your customers want to start making their holiday plans. And I would suggest you don't do this just once. You want to start now, but I think as we get closer and closer to the holidays, you can ramp up the frequency of all of this. You can start emailing more often as we get closer. You can start posting more holiday social media messages as we get closer. You know, right now, maybe you want to do one of each per week, and then a month from now, maybe you want to do two or three. By the time you're in November, you might actually want to stay around the same or maybe scale it back a little depending on what the availability looks like for holiday travel at that point. And I know you guys are all pretty active and engaged, so I know you know what's selling out and what's still available, and that might be a good tactic too as you get into November to say, hey, availability's filling up. Here's some ideas of what's still available and what's the best deals. You know, you maybe can't go to Jamaica because it's all full, but Have you considered this other place that's also really great and they have a lot more availability and the pricing is pretty good for holiday? So just some things to think about. And if you're not working with us right now, we want you to give yourself a great holiday gift and start working with us. So our website program, NextSight 2, includes all of the supplier content, and it's fully customizable so that it represents who you are and what you sell. So you can go in, you can set your supplier preferences, you can create different links to different types of content, you can put those on different pages, you can create as many unique pages as you want to really tell the story about your agency. Because every one of you is unique, you sell something different, you bring a different experience to your clients, and your clients are all unique. So we want to make it as easy as possible for your website to match kind of your personality and your agency style. So NextSight is $55 per month, and there is a one-time $150 setup fee. And there is also our social media product, which is called ESP. It's Facebook posting for travel agents. And this is custom curated content that's posted to your business Facebook page. And they're fun, relevant images and textual posts. Usually they're tied together. It's usually a combination of a photo with some compelling copy about the photo. And you have the ability to opt out of any post. So maybe let's say there was a post for domestic travel and maybe your agency doesn't sell that. Not a problem. You can go into your administrative interface, look at the posts that are scheduled to go out on your behalf, and just say, oh, you know what, that one's not going to be interesting to my clients. I'll just block it. So you click one button, and it won't go. And ESP respects your preferred suppliers. So when you set up your website with us and you go in and you say, you know, I don't want to sell this supplier at all, you'll never see those any posts for that supplier in your queue for your social media posts. And if you have NextSight, then you'll have some posts that will link back to your website. Sometimes we'll have supplier posts that talk about a specific promotion or a group of promotions. In those cases, those will lead back to your website, and your customer will be able to click on the link and view all of those promotions that were featured in your social media post. And so if you want some more information, here is our contact info, and I'm going to go ahead and open it up to questions. I know we went through this pretty fast, but everybody usually seems to have a lot of questions, and so I know it's much more engaging for you guys to be able to ask me your specific questions than for me to just talk to you for an hour.
Okay, great. Sarah, that was fantastic information. Very, very useful to all of us and great slides. Again, agents, if you have questions, now's a good time to type them in. On the right side of your screen, you'll see a area where you can type in your question, and we'll get some questions going. Sarah, you mentioned business and personal Facebook pages. What is the difference between those two, and does an agent need both?
That is a fantastic question. So there is a difference between the two. A personal page is for, as it kind of implies of the name, is for a person, one single individual person. And Facebook does not want you using one of those as a company. So they don't want you to go on and create a personal page for your company and, you know, fill in the first and last name as something and try to use that as your company. If they catch you, they can potentially delete your page, and then you'll have lost all of that work that you do. So don't do it. I would encourage you to not try to do that. Also, one of the other things about that is when you're using a business page for your business, if someone wants to like your business, they just click one button and it's done. But if you're using Facebook as a person, when someone wants to follow you, they have to request to be your friend and you have to agree to that. So there's a, you know, much more drawn out process to that, whereas with your business page, you don't have to agree to let them follow you. It just lets everyone who wants to follow you. So if you haven't set up a business page yet, encourage you to do it. It takes less than 3 minutes. If you go into Facebook and type in business page in the search bar at the top, I believe it will actually lead you right to the little creator where you can create those.
Fantastic. One of our agents wants to know if Passport Online's services are available to Canadian agents, and would you have Canadian preferred suppliers available to highlight on the websites? And do you have rates in Canadian dollars?
So the answer to all of those is yes. We do work with Canadian agencies, and we do have some Canadian suppliers, and we do have some offers that have pricing in Canadian dollars. So I would say give us a call, and we can get you the list of who those are and what specific Canadian content we have available, but we do.
Okay, excellent. If someone already has a website for her agency, would the next site to product be something that she could use?
If you already have a website and you want to keep that, we actually have a different product which is called VacationPort. We didn't cover that today, but it's essentially the same thing as NextSight. It's just not including the website building component, so it's just the supplier content and the email marketing tools. So we do have that available, and if you decide to go that route, we can give you some instructions on how to get it integrated onto your website. So if you just give us a call and tell them you're interested in VacationPort, they can get you some more info on that.
Okay. And we have a question again about the difference between personal and business page. And I'm just going to read the question as our agent typed it in. She says, I thought you have to have a personal Facebook page that you have to create the business page off of your personal page, that it actually makes you sign in to Facebook under your personal account. Is she understanding that correctly?
That is absolutely correct. So when you are logged into Facebook as your personal account, that's when you go in and you create your business page. It's not a separate account. It's just a page, and you can tie it to multiple different people's personal accounts. So if you had a number of people at your agency that you wanted to be able to manage your agency Facebook page, you can actually make them all admins. But you do initially have to create it while you're logged in as a personal account, and you do need to log in to Facebook as your personal account when you want to use your business account, which is a little confusing, but it's because the way they treat it is the business account is a page, not an account. So,
okay. So it's like the personal account is the hub, and you can have spokes coming off of that being a business.
Exactly. Okay. That's a great way to think of it. Because you can actually create multiple business pages, and I've seen some agencies that have gotten pretty creative with that because, let's say, for example, if you do honeymoons and you do family travel, it might not make sense for you to have one Facebook page where you're trying to promote both of those things, because people who are looking for a honeymoon are not necessarily going to want to see travel tips about how to travel with children. So it might actually be good to create two separate pages if you have kind of distinct different versions of your agency, of things that you sell.
And does Facebook charge for business pages?
They do not. You can create as many of them as you want, and it is free now. I don't see them changing that, but, you know, as one never knows with Facebook, but they have never charged for it, and I have not heard that they intend to, so you might as well take advantage of that now while you can.
Strike while the iron is hot, right?
Exactly.
One of our agents says, and this is again about Facebook, if we make another agent an admin for our business page, do they have access to all of our Facebook files and contacts?
No, they will only have access to just that business page. So all it does is allow them to see the statistics for the business page and to make posts to the business page. They won't be able to see any of your personal contacts, any of your personal messages, anything like that. So you're just kind of giving, you know, they're another hub, and you're just kind of connecting that spoke to both hubs, but you guys can't see each other's actual information.
Okay, wonderful. One of our agents has a question about the VacationPort product, and she wants to know what the price for that is.
The price for that is, I believe, $45 a month. It's a little bit cheaper than the NextSight, and it's the same setup fee. So I believe it's $45 a month.
Okay, great. I've had several agents mention to me over the last couple of years that if they were to pay attention to all the social media sites out there, it would be a full-time job just doing that. It's not just Facebook, it's Twitter and Instagram and Snapchat, and I don't know the names of all of them myself, and blogging and whatnot. What's your advice for how to narrow that down and you know, get to the most people with the fewest number of hours spent tending to social media.
Yeah, I tend to suggest that people try to find out what most of their clients are on, which in most cases is usually Facebook, and focus your efforts on that one channel. Instead of trying to do a little bit with every social media channel, do one and do it well. Because if you try to participate in, you know, 6-8 different social media channels, but you're not devoting yourself to it full time, you're really not ever going to get anything out of it, because you're not posting frequently enough, you're not doing any of those things. So pick one, stick with it. Also, our ESP product really helps to cut down on some of that with Facebook, because in the post for you, you can get up to 3 or 4 per day different posts that you have to choose from. So that cuts down a lot on having to find images to use, having to think of something to write, and things like that. We still want you to create your own custom posts, but we want you to do that when you have time and you have something that's really specific to your customers that you want to communicate. Not having to go, oh, it's Monday, I have to think of 6 or 7 different posts to put up for the rest of the week, and my phone's ringing and I'm stressed out. So that's mainly what ESP does, is takes that part out where you can go, okay, you know what? I'm working with customers, I'm making sales, I don't have time to worry about social media right now, I don't have anything specific I want to promote, I'm just going to let ESP handle it, get some kind of content out there, promote some nice destinations, have my clients still continue to see something on my Facebook page that they can interact with, but I don't have to worry as much about it.
That sounds good to me.
That's all of us. We're all busy.
Does ESP allow agents to copy the posts to other social media channels? Can they put them on Twitter and Instagram?
Yeah, they can actually take that content and share them to any other social media channels that they want to. So there is an integration, I believe, within Facebook where they can have it automatically share to Twitter. There's a little bit of setup work you'd have to do for that to happen, but you can do that. And then you can always, when you have a post that goes out and you think, oh, this would be cool for Instagram, you can always go to your Facebook page and then just save that image and the copy and put it onto Instagram, and that's absolutely fine.
Oh, that's wonderful. One of our agents says the following: I have heard that only a small percentage of actual followers see your Facebook content due to an algorithm that Facebook uses. Do you recommend ways to get your information out to more followers?
So there are some ways, of course, like with everything, it costs money. Facebook does have their boost technology, which you can use on individual posts. So my suggestion is, we have a couple agencies that were in one of our Facebook groups where they can talk to each other about social media and our ESP product, and they did some trials where they spent around $5 a day for a week or two and just would pick a post and boost it, and they saw some really great results. And the cool thing is that once you've done that, you'll still continue to reach more people after that. So even though you haven't boosted a post in 2 weeks, you're still getting an increase in activity. And the reason for that is because when you get that increase in activity, you're getting more people commenting, you're getting more people liking, all of that. And so Facebook says, oh, these people like these posts, they like this content, this is what they want to see, so let's show them more of it. So the way to do it without paying is to get people to like and comment and share your posts more, which is sometimes difficult without paying, but if you find something that really resonates with your clients, you can get that naturally. If you get a whole bunch of people commenting on it, saying, you know, anything really, just interacting with it, then Facebook will see, hey, this post is really popular, people really like it, I should show it to more of these followers.
Sarah, you know so much about social media. You're such an expert on all of this stuff. If someone were to have some of Passport Online's products, you know, if they were to buy some of Passport Online's products, is there also a way, do you have a mentoring program, or can they actually speak to you on the phone and get some feedback?
Sometimes they can. We do have a great Facebook group that I mentioned before, which if you're using our ESP product, you can join it, and it's free. And what it is it's, you can post on it like a news group, and other agents or me or other people at the company will respond provide feedback. And I will respond to things, but sometimes I'll wait to let other agents respond because sometimes their answers are even more valuable than mine, because if you're getting an answer from a peer who's done kind of the same thing that you've done and they've been in that same position and you're saying, you know, hey, I'm frustrated, I'm not getting a lot of activity, I don't know what to do. Somebody that can say, hey, I was there 6 months ago, this is what I did, this is what happened, it really did work. That's sometimes more powerful than me telling you something, because they're also an agent and they're also coming into this, you know, new. So
that's fantastic. And I think as most of us are home-based agents, we really need that networking to bounce ideas, to learn things, to teach things. It's a great idea. It's a great way to network with other people from the solitude of your home office. And in that,
absolutely,
in that vein, does Passport Online have any kind of in-person networking opportunities?
We haven't necessarily done any specific in-person networking, but that's a great idea. We do, you know, go to conferences, things like that. But I think that might be something for us to look into, doing a, you know, in-person networking opportunity, allow some of the agents to meet each other and share ideas, things like that.
Yeah, I think it's really important for home-based in particular. And one last question. And again, agents, if you think of a question after this webinar is over, you can give Passport Online a call. Sarah has the number up there. You can check out the website and see everything that Passport Online offers and see if you can get some of your questions answered. And the last question is, you mentioned that you should put the Facebook or Twitter or whatever icons on everything, so on your website, on the various pages, so that viewers of your websites can click on that and link to your Facebook page, and the little, the little bird for Twitter icon and the little F for Facebook. How does an agent actually do that? Do you do that from Facebook or do you do that from the website?
You actually do that from your website, and if you're using our NextSight tool, we make it so, so easy. We actually have a screen where you go into in your configuration, and it just has a list of all the different social media networks, and then all you do is just paste in there the link to your Facebook page in the Facebook link box, and it puts the icon in there, puts the link behind it, does everything for you.
Easy enough.
So easy.
Very easy. Well, this has been phenomenal. This has really been fantastic, and I urge our agents listening to this call, if you have not already started promoting holiday travel, that you do so. I know of at least one nationwide chain department store that has Christmas tree area in its stores already. So
really?
Our clients are seeing things about the holidays already, and this would be a great way to put the travel bug in their bonnet as well. Our host today has been Passport Online. Our fabulous speaker has been Sarah Bellman, Marketing and Product Analyst. Sarah, thank you so much. This was really wonderful information.
Well, thank you for having me. It's always great to talk with you. And if anyone has any questions, again, feel free to reach out, email or phone, and let us know, and we will get you all the answers.
Fantastic. And I want to thank our agents again for taking time out of your busy day to join us. We know you got a lot out of this, and we'll put it into action very soon. So thank you for being here. Enjoy the rest of your day. Happy autumn to everybody, and we'll see you next time. Bye, everyone.
Bye.